Hello everyone, Alex here from WarrenOffKeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create advanced polls that will automatically allow you to insert some text, like let's say this message here. I'll say what is your favorite language, and then we'll have different actual reactions here, which could be anything. For simplicity, I'm just going to use different colored circles. I'm going to set those equal to a certain text, and the equal sign is important here. Now what happens when I send this is it's going to automatically add in those reactions. And the channel will be set up where people can add to the existing reactions, but they cannot add their own reactions, and they also cannot type in this. So in a previous video, which I'll link in the video description, I created a simple poll command and added the ability for something like the suggestions channel where thumbs up and thumbs down are added, and that works well. However, in some cases, you may not just want thumbs up and thumbs down. You might want to have a bunch of different options, and so this system will allow you to do that, and we're going to get started right now. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the community category right here, and I'm going to create a new text channel. I'm going to call this polls, and I'm going to use this chart or graph emoji. I can then create the channel. I'm going to move it up to right here, which is where I want it. I can then go in and edit the channel permissions. We want people to not be able to read this for now. This is something I'll make public later on. Sending messages will be disabled. And scrolling down, we need to make sure that people cannot add reactions. So if we look at the description here, it says members with this permission can add new reactions to a message. Members can still react to reactions already added to the message without this permission. So with this said, if we disable this, they're not able to add in new reactions, but they are able to click on the actual existing reactions to then agree with something. And so that's what we want. We don't want people adding in random reactions, which will then confuse our results. We just want people to agree with what is already there. We can save this. Now going in here, we see that there's nothing here and only I have access to this. So now we can actually start writing the functionality. So here I have this project I've been working on throughout this series. If you don't have access to this, a link to this will be found in the video description with a GitHub repository. However, in this exact video, you can code along from scratch if you want. I'm going to start off by making a new file. I'll call this advanced-polls.js. This is simply going to export a new function that I'll take in a client as the argument. So I'm going to save this, and going back to the index file, I'm actually going to import this. So constant advanced polls equals require advanced polls. And then I'm going to call this passing in the client. Now we can save and close this file. All of our logic will be inside of here. And the first thing I want to do is above this, I'm going to create a constant. This will be an array called channels. And I need to go into Discord, and I'm going to right click on the polls channel and click on copy ID. If you don't see this, then you need to enable developer mode on your Discord account. I can go back and I can add this into my array. And so you can add in multiple channels here. If you had other channels, you can add them here as well. And then all the channels would share the same functionality. Now inside of here, I'm going to create a listener. So client.onMessage. And we're going to have a callback here, which will have our message object. I first want to get the content of the message. So I can destructure that because content is a property. And then I want to get each individual line. So I can create a constant called each line and set this equal to content.split upon a new line character. This is a special symbol that will basically just be a new line. And so when we split it, it's going to take a string of text such as hello world, and it's going to convert that into an array saying hello world, just like this. So this is exactly what we want. And to confirm this, we can console log saying each line. I can then restart the bot. I'm going to copy and paste in the message I have here, and we see an array with what is your favorite language, an empty string, and then the actual emojis don't get displayed on the console, but that's fine. Now we want to loop through each line and see if it contains an equal sign. So keep in mind that the equal sign is going to be something that is going to be important, so we can't just add equal signs randomly on other lines. The equal sign is basically going to say there's an emoji to the left of it and something else to the right of it. So with that said, we can go in here. We can loop through each line. So we're going to create a for loop, constant line of each line. And here we can say if line.includes equal sign. Now inside of here, we're going to want to split on that equal sign. So const split equals line.split equal sign. If we had, for example, this string right here, then it would essentially have one element of the array be this. So we're going to have an array like this. And then the second one will be space Python. And so we can now use this to be able to get access to the first index. And so we can say constant emoji equals split index 0 However, sometimes we're going to add a space. So for example here, there's a space in between the emoji and the actual equal sign, and so we want to use a built-in JavaScript function called trim, which will actually remove all excess spaces. And so in this exact case, this is just going to leave us with the emoji. Now with that, we can simply say message.react emoji. I can save this, I can restart the bot. I can go ahead and copy this right here, and if I paste it again, it will automatically add in the reactions as we expect. And then your users can go in and react to those depending on what their favorite language is. They can choose multiple. And this is something that you, whenever you feel like has enough data, you can then look at the results and make a decision based off of that. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.